Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to be doing a Q&A video for you because I've gotten a lot of new subscribers recently and I know a lot of you guys probably don't know that much about me, so you guys requested a Q&A video and I love doing these for you guys and letting you guys in a little bit more to like my personal life and stuff like that. So if you guys want more Q&As, then just give this video a thumbs up, and I know I'm gonna get questions about it. I did a makeup tutorial on this makeup look. I will link it down below for you guys to check it out if you are interested. But without further ado, let's just go ahead and get on into the questions. So I asked for Q&A questions on Instagram. That's normally where I do it. So if you guys do not follow me on Instagram yet, it's Kelly_JaneXX. Go and follow me and you can be part of my next Q&A. But thank you guys so much for everyone that asked questions. I always get like shocked when I put up like pictures asking for questions for Q&A and people like actually ask me questions because I'm like, why would anyone care like about me? But thank you guys so much for everyone that asked me questions. The first question is from Court148Kern, and she said, can you please start a series where you vlog? You are one of my favorites. Oh, and why are you so fabulous? Well, thank you so much. That means so much to me. And if you guys want me to start a series where I vlog, I can. I used to do like vlogs here and there, but like, it's really up to you guys. Like, for me, it's kind of hard since I'm a student. Like, a lot of my days are spent studying or at school, doing projects, like boring stuff like that. That's like not fun and exciting to vlog. But I mean, some of my days are fun too. So I can definitely vlog if you guys want me to, but just let me know down below in the comments. If you want me to do vlogs, I'll do them. Juicy Joss asked me, what are your plans after grad school? Love you, girl. I love you too, girl. Thank you so much for asking me a question. And you know what? That is such a loaded question too, because I really do not know what my plans are after grad school. I am graduating from grad school in May of this year, and I'm really kind of tossed in between like what I'm gonna do, whether or not I'm going to pursue like YouTube and beauty and stuff like that, or whether I'm gonna kind of do what I went to school for, because they are not the same thing. So yeah, I really don't know yet, and I really should probably like figure it out ASAP, and because graduation is quickly approaching, so I'm really not sure yet. GK Carter said, you are amazing. How old are you? How'd you get into YouTube? How long have you been doing YouTube? When did you really snowball and to begin to feel like a success? Love you. Well, thank you so much. I love you as well. And okay, so I already said how old I was. I'm 22. I'll be 23 in April. How'd you get into YouTube? So I always used to watch YouTube beauty videos for years before I started making them myself. And then one day I was just kind of like, I'm gonna film myself doing this. And I just like filmed myself with my MacBook camera, like horrible lighting in my dorm room in college, like when I had time in between classes. And that's just kind of how I got started. How long have you been doing YouTube? So I started, like I made my first video my sophomore year of college. So that would have been like 3.5 years ago now. But I wasn't very consistent with it then. I really started to become a lot more consistent with it my junior year of college. So like for the first year, I kind of just like put up a video here and there. So I've really been doing it like consistently for like 2.5 years. And then when did I really feel like it started to snowball into a success? You know, I don't really know. Like I'm very hard on myself. So I still am kind of like, you know, like I really want more subscribers. Like I still am like, you know, oh, like even though I have so many subscribers, I'm always like pushing myself to like get more and like create more videos that you guys like and everything else. Like I don't really know when I would say that it like snowballed into a success, because like my version of success is big. You know, like I think of people like Jaclyn Hill or Nicole Guerrero who have millions of subscribers, and I think of them as such huge successes. And not to say that somebody that doesn't have a million subscribers isn't a huge success, because I watch tons of smaller YouTube channels as well, but I really feel like I really want to grow my channel more for me to really feel like, oh, this is really a success. But it's a success beyond numbers wise because it makes me super happy, and so that's success. So I guess ever since the beginning, because it's just something that makes me happy, but numbers wise I feel like I'm still working towards that goal. Melanie21 asked me, hi, I watch you every day since day one. I love you. Thank you so much. I love you as well. And she said, my question is, will you and your boyfriend ever consider getting an apartment together? Yeah, definitely. Like right now I live in my parents' house because I am in school full time. But once I graduate and get a job and everything and am financially stable and like basically when I move out, I definitely think I will live with Steven at that point. Erin Laley asked me, would you ever consider moving to a larger city like New York or LA, or are you more of a hometown kind of girl? Love you so much. Thank you. I love you as well. And this is a really hard question that I have thought a lot about myself. You guys know I grew up not very far outside of New York City. That's where I still live. I do live in New Jersey, but I've always been close to the city. And I've thought many times about living in New York City, but I just don't think I could actually live like in New York City. I feel like that would be a little too much for me because I did grow up in the suburbs. I'm used to like driving a car everywhere, and like it just, I feel like me moving to New York would be a little too much. LA is a little different because I went out to LA and there's like downtown LA, which is much more city-like, but there are like outskirts of LA that are really not that city-like. So I liked that aspect of LA. I feel like I could live inside of Los Angeles, but I don't think I could actually live in New York City. I'm a little bit more of like a suburb that's really close to the big city type of girl. Like I want to be able to go home to like a house and like have a car to drive and everything and not have to rely on mass transit while still being able to easily get to a big city, if that makes sense. Because that's just kind of like how I grew up, so that's kind of like how I envision myself when I get older. Amanda Langford asked me, what was your major in college? What are you studying in grad school? What kind of job do you want to have? Okay, so my undergraduate major was, I was a double major in human resource management and labor studies and employment relations. I know it's a mouthful. It's basically like management from like the human social sciences side of things. And then in grad school, I'm getting my master's in human resource management. As far as what kind of job I had, I kind of already talked about this. I really don't know. I am so torn because like from an academic standpoint, I love human resource management. It's always been like what I like to learn about and stuff, like in school. But I'm super passionate about like YouTube and beauty, and like that is my true passion, and I don't really feel that same passion with HR, even though I like HR and I could see myself being happy doing that. I think I would be so much happier doing something like in the beauty community. So I'm really torn. Like I really don't know. You know, I love YouTube and everything like that, so I would love to be able to do that full time, but I'm not sure if I'll be able to or not, just, you know, money wise and stuff. Like I feel like a lot of times people think YouTubers make so much money and we don't. I mean, I'm sure if I had like a million subscribers, it would be different, but yeah, we don't make enough money to be able to live. At least I don't. So, yeah, I'm really torn, but hopefully, you know, one day my channel will grow to a million subscribers and I will be able to do it full time for you guys, and that would be amazing. Sammy9684 asked me, what brushes do you recommend from the drugstore? So I absolutely love Real Techniques brushes. I think they're amazing. I like their complexion sponge as well, which is kind of like a drugstore version of the Beauty Blender. So I would definitely recommend Real Techniques. Check them out. They have really, really great brushes. They're a little like more expensive than like other drugstore brands. Like I'm trying to think, there's one called like Eco Tools. I don't like them as much. They are cheaper than Real Techniques, but Real Techniques is really great and it's not nearly as expensive as like Sigma or MAC. HJohnson94 asked me, do you dye your hair? What do you do to it? So this question I got repeated a lot of questions about my hair. So I'm gonna let you guys know as much as I know because I do not do my hair myself. That was a lot of questions on that too. I get my hair professionally done. I naturally have red hair. So if you're new to my channel, you might be like, what? I mean, some of you guys obviously know that. But yeah, I naturally have red hair. I get it highlighted and low lighted. So my highlight is a blonde color, just like a really light blonde. And then my low light is an ash blonde, like a dark ashy blonde color. So I get both of those put into my hair and it pretty much takes out like all of the redness of my hair, even though I still, at some parts of my hair, you could see some pieces of the red, but I kind of like having that like dimension to my hair. But I've been coloring it, like highlighting it for like, I want to say probably at least 8 years. So I feel like most of my hair like isn't even red anymore because it's just all the color of the highlights and the low lights. So that's what I do. I got a lot of questions about toners that are used on my hair as well. There is no toner used on my hair. I really think that since I use that ashy blonde low light, it just tones my hair and I don't have to use like any other type of toner. I do use purple shampoo here and there. My favorite one is the Matrix So Silver. But as far as like an actual toner, none is used. StacyCole13 also asked me, do you still use Bellamy extensions? If so, I'd like to see how you install them. So yes, Bellamy are the only extensions that I use. I do still wear them all the time and I have a video on how I clip them in, so I will link it in the bottom bar if you want to see. AlwaysInfinity10 asked me, how did you lose weight? You are beautiful. Thank you so much. So for me, it was like kind of a lot of things combined because for 4 years when I was at undergraduate school, I lived at college. So I lived in an off-campus apartment at the college that I went to, and then now when I'm in my final year for my master's program, I commute from home. So for 4 years I lived on my own and was kind of just like not eating very healthy. Like I didn't have that much money to spend on food because everybody in college was like crazy poor, including myself. So I didn't have tons of money to buy like super healthy food all the time and always have like fresh fruit and fresh vegetables, because that can get really expensive, and especially when you're only buying it for yourself, like one person. If you buy like a big thing, then you're not gonna eat it, you're gonna throw so much out. So it was hard to eat like super healthy, and I also obviously had a meal plan, which is where I got most of my meals in. So I just wasn't eating as healthy as I should have been. I always like try to eat healthy, but I ate a lot of carbs, a lot of like processed food and stuff like that. So when I came home, I was able to eat like fresh vegetables, fresh fruit, much less processed food, and a lot less carbs as well. I still eat carbs. Like, I love carbs. I could never cut them out entirely. I really could not, and be happy at the same time. Like, I just would not be able to do that. So when I came home and just started to eat healthier and kept up the same workout routine, it just worked really well. So yeah. MaddieB66 asked me, how long does it normally take you to get ready in the morning? So it really depends like what we're talking about, because like on a typical day, like if I'm just going to school, I get up and I am out the door in like 30 minutes because I literally just throw on BB cream, a little bit of concealer underneath my eyes, and some mascara on my top lashes and go. Like, I don't even do brows, and it's like a big deal if I put some lip balm on. Then I'm like presenting something in my class. I feel like when I tell people at school that I like have a beauty YouTube channel, they're kind of like, oh, like, because I just always look like not with a lot of makeup or anything on at school, because I just have to get out the door like super quick because I have early classes. So yeah, I can get ready super, super quick. Like, from the time my alarm goes off to the time I am out the door, it's only like 30 minutes. And in that time, I'm like getting ready, eating breakfast, like getting my backpack and everything together and in the car. So, but on a day like today, like if I'm doing my makeup full out, it'll take me more like an hour or so. Like, obviously I've perfected it. It used to take me longer, but since I've kind of got more like into makeup and I do it a lot more often now, like on camera and stuff for you guys, I can do it faster, which is a good thing. So normally it'll take me about an hour or so. Attribute1 said, how long have you and your boyfriend been together? Do you think you will get married? So yeah, I definitely do think that we will get married eventually. Like, people ask me all the time, like, if I think we're gonna get married, because we have been dating for 7 years. Our anniversary was on January 1st, so it's like 7 years and a month or so now. And yeah, so I mean, I definitely think that we will get married, but not anytime soon. I mean, we're both 22 years old. I feel like that's a little young, at least for me, to wanna get married. I feel like there are so many other things that I'm so focused on in my life right now, that I don't have time to like plan a wedding or do any of that type of stuff. But yeah, I mean, I definitely do think we will get married, just not right now. Cindy Lou, who asked me, if you could travel anywhere in the world, where and why? So I have like a scroll, like a rolling list of like all the places that I want to travel to. But if I could only pick one, I would probably say... That's so hard. I'm going to tell you guys all the places that I want to go to, like my tops, because I really can't choose in between them because they all just seem so beautiful. So my top places that I want to go to are Greece, which, because you guys are going to think I'm crazy, but I saw it on a Kardashian episode. They like all went there on a vacation and it was so beautiful. And I've just seen so many pictures and it looks so beautiful. So I would love to go to Greece, then Italy and France, because those are like the two places in Europe that interest me the most, because I've never been to Europe, and Italy because apparently the food is amazing. So I would just eat my way through Italy. And then for France, I would want to go and like, I hear like the fashion and everything is really, really great there. So I would love to go that to France for that. And then the only other place that is like top on my list is Spain, because I took Spanish, like the language, throughout my entire education. So I know, like, I mean, I'm not like fluent in it or anything like that, but I know a decent amount of Spanish, and I really just like the culture and stuff. Like, I'm no Spanish at all, but I just really like the culture, I guess, because I learned so much about it in all my classes. So I would love to be able to travel there and see it. Sage asked me, if you could be on any reality TV show, what would it be? I would choose The Amazing Race. That is a good choice, because then you'd be able to see all those places that I just talked about, plus more, like the whole world. So that would definitely be a really cool reality show to be on. This is so hard because I actually watch a lot of reality TV. And my two favorite, I know what I would pick. I would definitely pick The Real Housewives of wherever I live, you know, New Jersey as of right now, or if I end up moving, The Real Housewives of wherever I live. I would love to be a real housewife. I love those shows. And I also love The Bachelor, but obviously I have a boyfriend, so I can't go on The Bachelor, but I love The Bachelor. I would love to just be like, on The Bachelor and like not be a contestant, but just like watch everything like in real time. Like I think that would be really cool because I'm obsessed with The Bachelor. If you guys watch The Bachelor, let me know who your pick is for Ben down below, like who you think he's gonna pick in the end. I love talking about it. But yeah, I guess I would choose The Real Housewives of New Jersey or wherever I was living.